Okay, so welcome back to Studio Build Journal number 5. Today I would like to catch up with everything that has happened here so that I can make more videos in real time whenever something new is happening. I would also like to share some more details regarding the construction as well as some of the audio stuff that I left out in the past videos. In the last update video we left things at the time that the whole soundproofing was supposedly done, and if you've watched that video you know that I wasn't really pleased with the results. If you haven't watched it, it was my opinion after some tests that that way of soundproofing was not something viable for a recording studio. So let's get into some more details. The old construction was based on the idea of room in a room, and it consisted of two separate systems. The first one was the wall and the ceilings, which were connected, and the second one was an independent light construction floating floor. So the construction of the wall and the ceilings went like this. After leaving a very small space of about 1 or 2 centimeters from the existing wall, there was a layer of insulation about 5 centimeters thick, and after that a double layer of drywall with mass-loaded vinyl between it. The ceiling, which was connected with the walls, was also a double layer of drywall with mass-loaded vinyl between it and a layer of insulation above it. It was hanging from some springs from the existing ceiling. Regarding the floor, because we couldn't safely do a reinforced concrete floating floor because this whole studio is on the first floor, we opted for a lighter construction which consists of 3 layers of MDF seated on top of rubber pads and rock wool. The problem was that after that construction didn't provide the results that I was hoping for, nobody seemed to know how it could be made any better. So after a lot of reading and research on my part, I proposed something that I hope has made things better. While their proposal was to build another layer of insulation on top of the existing ones, after a little bit of research, I found out that this would not be optimal because we would create a triple leaf system. For anybody who doesn't know what this is, I didn't either. It basically means that you create 2 gaps between walls during your soundproofing construction, and in most cases it's much better to just have 1 bigger gap than 2 little ones. I will include an article in the description below so that you can get more in-depth information on this matter. What I proposed instead was this: we could remove the existing drywall while keeping the insulation, and we could add a new layer of insulation and drywall which would be seated on top of the floating floor. This would be connected with the hanging ceiling so that we could create something totally independent from the floor, the walls and the ceiling. So that's what was done. I really hope that this made things better, and now I have something that is more viable as a recording studio. I really haven't tested it much during this time because, well, nobody can come here, but I hope very soon I will put it through its paces. Something that I forgot to mention in the past update is that the 2 rooms are connected with 32 channels of audio cables. 24 of them are microphone inputs from the live room to the control room, and 8 of them will be returns to the live room, which will be used for headphone mixes, reamping and stuff like that. Also, because the 2 rooms are not next to each other, they will be communicated with a system consisting of cameras and 2 TV monitors. They will be the window of the studio. Okay, I think that's all. The next step will be the acoustic treatment of both rooms. I already have the panels here. We have made some first measurements of both rooms so that we can see what needs to be done. But I'm waiting for this whole situation to pass so that we can place everything in the correct position and do the final measurements in both rooms. So the next video in the journal will be addressing the acoustic treatment part, and then I want to do some videos regarding the studio desk that I built for this place, as well as some other interesting stuff that will happen in here. Okay, that's all for today. If you have any more questions regarding this construction, let me know in the comments. Also, if you want to stay up to date with the Studio Build Journal, consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Dalam, and I'll see you in the next one.